Naturally, our memory is a network which are connecting things to each other. Our memory files, it is filing system. That system, we have to copy and practically use it when we are memorizing something. So we link things to each other. For example, if you go to an old school for you, maybe before 10 years or 20 years, if you go, for sure you will remember details. Those are filed in that location, in that position. Those old teachers, old classmates, some incidents happened in that school. When you attend there, you'll remember a lot of details. Those details, they have been in your memory, but it was difficult to remember them while you were another place. But when you have attended this place, when you have become in this place, you remember them, all of those details. Why? Because they have linked to this location. They have filed into this location, to that old school. So that is a natural way of memorizing something. So whenever you wanted to memorize something, please link it to something you know, some location you know, some place, some other familiar information to you. Link it. Also, organizing is the one of the biggest principles that will help you. If you go to the library and you are looking for maybe a medicine book, and all of those shelves, the books, there is no catalog, there is no organizing, there is no system, computerized system in that level. How you will find that book? How you can find that book? It will be difficult for you. Finding of that piece of information or maybe the book or something else in unorganized system, it will be difficult for you. That is also your memory. It is like a library. When you are putting the information, you have to organize them in a logical way. That is how our memory works. If you want to remember something easily, you have to give your whole attention. You have to give it. Also, you have to make it outstanding. Those things you are memorizing, we can remember those abnormal things, those exaggerated scenarios. We can remember, isn't it? If you are taking the street, you are meeting a lot of people, you are facing them each other, but you don't care. But if you finally get someone with outstanding, strange way, maybe he have color all over his body, or maybe he's wearing some strange clothes or whatever, any strange way of things happening outside in our life or in the streets, in the markets, even in the videos when we are consuming, everything looks like for us strange. We can recall it easily, instant way. Those things that you are going to memorize, you have to make them outstanding, easy to remember also. Make it in action, in a movement. That's why we can remember those movies, those TV shows, when we are watching them. At the end of the videos, if they ask you some basic questions, you will answer them. But if you have been reading a book, at the end of the book, if they ask you 10 questions, it's difficult even to answer one of them. That is how it's difficult. And that is how it is good to change things into movements, into action. You have to involve everything. Try to involve images, actions, makes you great. Reviewing and the revision of is the mother of memory rules. It will help this piece of information to go deep in your memory, deep in your system. You have read some book now, and then after a few hours, you come and scan it, you know, memorize it and get some basic information. And after one day, if you also glance it and see main topics and titles, and after 1 week also do the same 5 minutes, after 1 month, a lot of details in that book, a lot of main points, main details, topics, titles will be stored in your long-term memory. That's the revision. That is the power of revision. Understanding of the memory is the first responsibility you have. If you don't understand this system, it's difficult to use it. This laptop, if I don't understand it, it's difficult to use it. So as the memory. If we don't understand our memory, it's difficult to use it. You know We are capable when it comes to the power of our memory. But the challenge is the way we are managing it, the poor management, the mismanagement. Our memory has a lot of abilities, but if we don't understand the way we are using, it will be underperforming. So I will explain a lot of methodologies, a lot of methods that will change the entire information into pictures, to images, and link them to each other to make associations, the entire visualization process. I will explain it in the other video. So please stick with me, subscribe this channel, and also like the video for YouTube algorithm. Thanks for watching. See you soon.